Nonprofit Cape Coral Friends of Wildlife is working to repopulate our state butterfly. Today they released a dozen in Rotary Park. Hurricane Ian wiped out the main food source for the zebra longwing. NBC2's Alicia Alonso shows you why today's release was so important.
While their wings have dried and these 12 butterflies are ready to be released, Cape Coral Friends of Wildlife says this is their biggest release yet.
Not in decline statewide, but in decline here because of the decimation. This happened after Hurricane Charlie, too.
Cheryl Anderson is working to repopulate the state butterfly throughout southwest Florida. The zebra longwing butterfly lays eggs on the passionflower plant, but many were destroyed by Hurricane Ian.
I'd like to think what we're doing is just giving them a jump start, okay? Because they would come back. As the corky stem come back, they would come back. We're just trying to give it a little bit of help.
Anderson raises the species at the butterfly house in Rotary Park.
You see the yellow dots? Oh yeah. Those are the zebra eggs.
Watching eggs grow into caterpillars until they form chrysalises like this. Today, 12 zebra longwings broke free of their protective shells, ready to be released.
These are not migratory butterflies. These aren't like the monarchs that travel from north to south. These butterflies pretty much stay all their lives.
Anderson says preserving the passionflower plant will only help the butterflies repopulate in our area. For years, the plant has been mistaken as a weed.
See, it just has these kind of, you know, triangular type leaves. It looks like an English ivy. And it grows on things. It'll grow on your bushes. It grows up the palm trees here at the park.
The zebra longwings are now flying free in the park, taking in their first meals of nectar.
Hey guys,
one.
Two.
Two.
Reporting local in Cape Coral, Alicia Alonso, NBC2.